myself for this Diwali Eve. To understand much of what I have done or not done, we need to look at it from a prism of a certain experience I had while preparing for the speech. At home, in front of the mirror, I was a picture of eloquence. Words were rolling out of my tongue. I was full of energy and vigor, and I felt like a caged lion. I had a beard and long hair. I felt like a caged lion. And I was rattling my cage, asking, where is the stage? Where is the audience? My wish was granted. I was sitting there. Being there, I asked myself, oh, land inside, can you give me that reassuring roar? Not a sound. Cool October evening must be sleeping, I thought. I asked again, oh, land inside, can you give me some sound? Not a sound. I was concerned. Wrong time to be sleeping. I asked again, please say something. And I hear it. And I know the greatest of my challenges is alive and well, the one of helping the creature within find its own voice. It is to work on that that I keep coming here every Friday evening. Let's leave my motives aside and come down to the nuts and bolts of the story. A warm good evening, Mr. Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters and guests. My name is George Matthew and I was born over a quarter of a century ago in Kerala. That place is known for two things, literacy and liquor. Literacy has hit me and I am quite well for it. Liquor has flown by. Well, we are all apes, creatures who imitate. If the place where we are born has a deep influence on us, so profound is the influence of our family. And of my family, I have to say this. From my mother, I have learned two things, kindness and compassion. She is a doctor by profession. I have seen her practice this with her patients. Being a child, I feel blessed and grateful. From my father, who is a professor in history, I've learned a thing or two. The thing is, he's always told me to take everything and anything that comes in life with a pinch of salt. Salt of skepticism. For you can never know what motives men or institutions have when they present a fact to you. And from my brother, who's 2 years my younger, and an engineer, I've learned quite a large number of things. Well, as a child, I've been an okay kid. But at times I could be a tyrant, and when I was, he was the one who bore the brunt of much of my violence. Being a kid, he took it with a grace and still cannot fathom. And when he grew up, he showed me the folly of my ways in a most non-violent manner that has left a lasting impression. For that, I am grateful. Like most of you, I went to school and learned the 3 R's. First, reading, which is a joy. Writing, a passion. And the third, wrestling. I learned it from a friend called arithmetic. the fact is, I made a lot of good friends in school and lost most of them to engineering. The thing is, many of them had such profound knowledge of the subject that they would, without batting an eyelid, say 1 plus 1 equals 3. I, however, was made of less sterner stuff and chose to read law. For that, I went to Symbiosis in Pune. When most people reminisce about their college days, they say, oh, the stately columns, oh, the green lawn, oh, the girls with the eyes, the color of melting chocolate. Well, for me, college was a drab affair. Colloquially, the place was known as a 9BHK. It was a very small thing, but the place was filled with a lot of intelligent people. The company was good. And from the chocolate eyes, I learned this. Well, soft-spoken nerds don't stand much of a chance before macho motormouths. Moving on, in college I discovered a passion for quizzing. Quizzing, it's a subject, it's a craft which teaches you two things. One, humility for the things you don't know. And second, it rewards you for things that you don't know, you do know. After college, I took up a job, and under my job I have to say this. It's a jealous mistress. She let you play around and have fun, but when the time comes, she'll demand her pound of flesh and you better give it. All that is in my past. Of the future, how would I like to live it? Do two things. One, to serve fellow men. And two, equip myself to do that. This is in essence my quintessence. Thank you all.